Okay, today's video is going to cover slope from graph. So here we have this line that's graphed on a coordinate plane, and coordinate plane is an xy plane. And what we're going to do is we're going to deduce from this line the slope, which again is just how much the line rises, or the change in the rise over the change in the run. And we need 2 points to do this. You can't calculate the change unless you have at least 2 points. So the first step here would be to identify 2 points that we can use. So we're looking for where this blue line goes through the corner of a square. So it goes through the corner of a square right there. It doesn't go through the corner right there. That's why we can't use it. We can't deduce the coordinates. It just misses it right there. And it goes through the corner right here. Okay, so between those 2 points, all we're doing is we're identifying the slope. Based on the direction of this line, I know that it's going to be a positive slope. And now I just got to count the number of boxes that the line rises over the number of the boxes that the line runs. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch color and calculate the rise. So the rise is 1 box, 2 boxes, 3 boxes, 4 boxes, and now we're even with that point. So the rise, or the change in the y between those 2 points, would be 4. And the change in the run, we're gonna do the same thing, but this time we're calculating the change in the x. So it changes 1x value, 2x values, 3x values, 4x values, 5x values, and now we're even with that point. So 4 over 5 would be the slope. And now I'm just punching that in right here, 4 over 5, I'm hitting check, and moving on to the next problem. Okay, for the second example, we're going to go ahead and use the Desmos version. So for the Desmos version, all we need to do is deduce 2 points that we can use and what those coordinates are. So this point goes perfectly to the corner of the square. So we can use this coordinate point, which would be for the x value 4, the x value, and the y value would be negative 2, so 4 comma negative 2. And then for the y value, I'm sorry, and then we need a second point. Let's go ahead and choose this point right here. For the x value, it'd be 1, comma, for the y value, it would be 1 as well, comma. And now I'm just gonna go over here, I'm gonna add a table, and I'm gonna type in the first coordinate point, 4 for x, negative 2 for y, and I'm gonna type in the second coordinate point, 1 for x, and 1 for y, and then I'm gonna link this table to the linear regression equation, so y1, shift the key next to the one on the keyboard is the squiggly, mx1 plus b, and this black line is the same as this blue line, and the reason why I know that is because the coordinate points come from this blue line. And I'm just looking down here, the slope is -1, and I'm going over to con and I'm typing in a -1. Okay, I'll go ahead and do one last example. This time I'm not going to write anything, so I'm looking at this graph, I'm looking to see where the line goes through the corner. It goes through the corner right there, so that coordinate point would be 1 for x and 2 for y, so I'm going to go ahead and put in 1 for x and 2 for y, and I need another coordinate point that where the line goes perfectly through the corner. The line goes perfectly through the corner right here, which would be 2 for x and 4 for y, so I'm going to replace x with 2 and y with 4. And you can see that this black line is now the same as this blue line, and the slope is 2. I'm getting that from Desmos, where it says m equals 2. So I did one example by counting, and one example by utilizing Desmos with the table and the equation. Good luck.